Distinguished participants and guests, Excellencies, Dr. Sameer Saran, Dr. Sanjay Joshi of the Observer Research Foundation, we have come to the close of the sixth edition of the Raisina Dialogue. I would like to begin by thanking the participants in the dialogue. There have been 4 days of rich discussions with 50 sessions, 150 speakers from 50 nations and multilateral organizations participated and contributed to these discussions in multiple formats. The speakers included heads of state and government, ministers, senior civilian and military officials from numerous nations, and very eminent experts and thought leaders from all countries. In terms of participation, this has set the bar for future editions of the Raisina Dialogue. This is also the first virtual edition of the dialogue. It is my understanding that viewers from almost 100 countries logged in to one or more of its sessions. The dialogue was followed and viewed widely through various social media handles. I believe that the number of viewers through such channels is unprecedented. I would like to thank all of these virtual spectators and observers for their interest in the proceedings. This dialogue took place in very challenging circumstances. We convened in the shadow of a great disruption, which has forever changed the way we live. This is the time of the uncertain, the unexpected, and the unknown. I am glad to note that the dialogue has focused attention on themes and ideas that will help navigate and decipher the difficult time. It is apparent that we must all work together to solve the problems that we are confronted with. Globalization, our Prime Minister stated in his opening remarks, must benefit all and must be relevant to the problems of our time. The External Affairs Minister defined true commitment to globalization as actions that are equitable, actions that leave no one behind, and actions that are imbued with good. We note with appreciation in this context the remarks of His Excellency President Paul Kagame about India's vaccine production capacity and sense of solidarity. Her Excellency, the Prime Minister of Denmark, highlighted that we are on the brink of a green industrial revolution, a green transformation underpinned by initiatives such as the India-Denmark Green Strategic Partnership is very much in the realm of the possible. Secretary Kerry highlighted the potential of emerging technologies in tackling climate change and its causes and consequences. Experts spoke of the need for policies and actions that drive energy transitions and increased electricity generation, sustainable transport, and sustainable urbanization that preserve and rebuild natural assets, accelerate industrial and tech transformations, and build resilience. The broader theme of connect technology and geotechnology ran through the dialogue. How technology can be harnessed to help and not hurt is one of the great questions of the day. Algorithms must help, not harm. Transparency is required. Forward-looking and positive rules that are congruent with good public policy, with protecting legitimate free speech, and with promoting accountability and transparency are required. The shortcomings of the current multilateral system laid bare by the pandemic evoked discussion. There is no retreat from multilateralism or globalization. Multilateralism needs to be strengthened. Where required, plurilateralism will play a complementary and supplementary role. New governance structures that address contemporary threats and non-traditional challenges will need to be created. His Excellency, the Prime Minister of Australia, flagged interest in the geopolitics of the Indo-Pacific. His Excellency, the European Council President, spoke of the need for an open and stable Indo-Pacific. Several dimensions of this pressing geopolitical question were discussed at depth. It has been, ladies and gentlemen, an enlightening 4 days of virtual debate and discussion. I'm sure that all of you will agree with me that this was time well spent. It is now time to close this edition of the dialogue. Before I do so, I would like to place on record the deep appreciation of the Ministry of External Affairs to our partners, the Observer Research Foundation. Special thanks are due to Dr. Sameer Saran and his team. They were more than equal to the complex logistical challenges posed by the current circumstances and reacted with agility and speed to developments. They framed the discussions and conducted the proceedings with skill and knowledge. I am sure that you will all agree with what I earlier said in my remarks. This edition of the Raisina Dialogue sets a new and high bar for future editions. I would be remiss if I did not thank the External Affairs Minister for his constant and steady guidance and for his unwavering support. I look forward to seeing all of you at the 7th edition of the Raisina Dialogue in 2022. Thank you. Namaste.